Some fans are happy, some not so much when it comes to the Buffalo Bills' first selection in the 2020 NFL Draft, the 54th overall pick, AJ Epenesa. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Believers Talk. My name is Joe, and welcome to this 2020 NFL Draft Profile Edition of Believers Talk, where we take a look at the Buffalo Bills 2020 NFL Draft picks, and we give you a player profile. This is the first one that we're doing, so obviously we're talking about the Buffalo Bills' first draft pick, and that's the 54th pick overall in the NFL Draft, second round pick. That's AJ Epenesa out of Iowa. So we want to talk a little about AJ Epenesa. I'm going to give you my initial reactions, and then I'm also going to let you know how Bills fans should really be feeling about this pick. Before I do that, however, I want to remind everyone, if you're not already subscribed to Believers Talk, guys, make sure you hit that subscribe button. I know a lot of you are enjoying still probably some great Buffalo Bills live draft content. I'm enjoying it as well, and I'm looking forward to the next Buffalo Bills pick. But right now, we need to keep you up to date on AJ Epenesa. Again, like this video, leave a comment, let me know what you think about AJ Epenesa, let me know what your initial reactions were, and now that you've had some time to think about it, what do you think now that the smoke has settled, so to speak. So my initial reaction on AJ Epenesa was right position, wrong player. One of my knocks on AJ Epenesa is not that he's not a great player. I really think he is and has a chance to be a really, really great player in the NFL. I just didn't think he fit the scheme for the Buffalo Bills. I was looking at more of like a Weaver from Boise State, as someone who could come in and fit Coach Leslie Frazier's defensive scheme a little bit better. So that's where I was looking at as far as the NFL draft went with the 54th overall pick. But you have to admit that AJ Epenesa is a talented young man who should have probably been off the draft board by the time the Buffalo Bills picked. So as a Bills fan, we've been saying, leading up to the draft process, leading up to the NFL draft, we've been saying, hey, the Bills are in great position to take best player available. And some of you are really happy with the AJ Epenesa pick, and I have no knock on that. I think, again, that the Buffalo Bills could really benefit here from what AJ Epenesa can give us. If we remember correctly, early on in the draft process, when you talk about those early mock drafts, AJ Epenesa was not even expected to fall to the Buffalo Bills when we had the 22nd overall pick. So to see him drop to 54th, first of all, it's great, right? You get a very talented player who you know that will be able to play come next season and make an impact immediately as long as he's used correctly, which we have to be honest with ourselves, we can trust the Buffalo Bills coaching staff, including Leslie Frazier, including Coach McDermott, to use him properly, to use him the way that benefits him the most. We saw what they did with Ed Oliver, moving him around. You know, at Houston, he played nose tackle. We had to move him a little bit on the defensive line to defensive tackle, and he succeeded, especially towards the second half of the year, succeeded at defensive tackle for the Buffalo Bills. So there's no reason to think that the defensive coaches cannot get AJ Epenesa in a place to be the most beneficial to him and make the biggest impact for this team. So AJ Epenesa played high school ball at Edwardsville, Illinois. So he's from Illinois. Played college ball, like we said, at the University of Iowa, was an Iowa Hawkeye, was recently selected by the Buffalo Bills in the 2020 NFL Draft with their second round pick. Pick 54 overall. He's a defensive end, 6'6", 280 pounds, so pretty good size for a defensive end. So earlier I talked about how he originally was mocked to go in the first round, some people not even having him falling out of top 15. So you might ask yourself, well, why then did he fall? And I'll tell you why he fell. He fell because of the underwear Olympics, right? He's one of those players who did not perform well in the NFL Combine, and due to the fact he couldn't have a pro day due to the current situation surrounding the entire world, then it really hurt his draft stock, it seems like. like in this instance that he couldn't try to do better than what he did at his NFL at the NFL Combine. His NFL Combine numbers, I'm going to give you those. I'm also going to give you the average numbers for defensive ends since 2000, so you guys can kind of see that he didn't measure up as well as the average defensive end would. And remember, when you talk about first round pick, you're talking about above average, right? I mean, if you talk about average, you're talking about all the defensive ends that went from the first round to the seventh round. So when you're talking about a first round pick, you want those guys to hit those numbers and hit those numbers regularly, including at the NFL Combine. So at the NFL Combine, AJ Epenesa ran a 5 second 40, 5.04 to be exact. The average time for a defensive end is 4.8 even. So that's one of the reasons why you might have seen him fall a little bit into the second round, about 0.2 seconds more than the average defensive end when it comes to 40 time. Now, when you're talking about a defensive end, 40 time doesn't really matter, right? In fact, when you're talking about a defensive end, you really want to look at that 20-yard shuttle time more than you would the 40-yard dash time, but he wasn't above average there either. In fact, he was just about average at his time at the 20-yard shuttle. The average 20-yard shuttle time is 4.42. His shuttle time at the 2020 NFL Combine was 4.46, so fell a little bit above that. He even fell a little bit above that three cone drill, which is, again, another very important drill for your defensive ends. When the average is 7.23, his three cone drill was 7.34, so about 0.1 seconds higher than the average in the NFL. He did have 17 reps and a 32.5-inch vertical leap. Pretty good for a defensive end. You talk about his length, you talk again about his size, this guy has it. So you have to be happy about that. And when you play in a system like a Brandon Bean, Coach McDermott, Coach Leslie Frazier system, especially Coach Leslie Frazier since he's playing for defense, you know that the defensive end is going to be a rotational player anyway, right? You're not going to have a defensive end playing 80, 90% of snaps. At most, your defensive end might be giving you 65% of snaps here in Buffalo. So that's when a fill-in player like an AJ Epenesa is going to fill in really well, especially early on in the 2020 NFL season. You look at AJ Epenesa's sophomore season, he actually didn't start a single game for the Iowa Hawkeyes, and yet he was still named second Big Ten team, or second all Big Ten. So that's really impressive considering he did not start a single game his sophomore season. And we'll get to his stats here in a little bit. Again, he went to high school at Edwardsville, Illinois, went to college at Iowa, was picked in the second round by the Buffalo Bills. In 2017, we're going to talk about these numbers. He played 3 years of college football at the University of Iowa. In 2017, he, again, did not start a single game. However, he was put in a relief role, had 15 tackles, 5.5 tackles for a loss. That's going to be one of those numbers that continue to jump out at you as I go through his stats, tackles for a loss. Another stat that will continue to jump out at you are his sack numbers. Talking about 4.5 sacks his first season at Iowa, 1 forced fumble. So then you go on to 2018, he gets a little more playing time, of course, because he proved that he can earn it, and the seniors from Iowa would graduate, so he gets more time as a sophomore at that point. 37 tackles, 16.5. tackles for a loss. So you're talking about more than a third of his tackles being in the backfield. That's pretty impressive if you're anybody. So we really like to see that, a guy that knows how to get into the backfield and knows how to get to the quarterback. 10.5 sacks in 2018 and 4 forced fumbles. In 2019, his numbers continue to improve. 49 tackles, 15 tackles for a loss, 11.5 sacks, and again, 4 forced fumbles. So you're talking about a guy that in 3 seasons has forced 9 fumbles. We'll take that every day of the week. 3 fumbles a season on average for an 11-game season. If he gets us 4 fumbles a game, we're okay with that. We'll accept that from a rotating defensive end position. 11.5 sacks, 10.5 sacks. You're talking about 26 sacks in 3 seasons. So those are numbers we're going to take every single day of the week. And you're talking about 36 or 37 tackles for a loss. So again, a guy that knows how to get in the backfield and knows how to create disruption. Better in the passing game than in the running game. His run defense still needs a little bit of work, still needs a little bit of improvement, But he has plenty of time to learn those things under Coach McDermott and under defensive coordinator Leslie Frazier. Let's talk about some of this guy's positives, right? AJ Epenesa, again, second round draft pick by the Buffalo Bills in the 2020 NFL draft. Again, guys, if you haven't already hit that thumbs up button, hit that thumbs up button. It really helps out the channel. And comment, let me know what you guys think about AJ Epenesa. I'm going to tell you some of my pros and cons from AJ Epenesa, and I really would like to hear what you guys have to say about him. I mean, one thing that you have to admit that no one can deny is his size. Again, you're talking 6'6", 280 pounds, but he also knows how to get his hands up. And I feel like at the defensive end position, especially for a team like the Buffalo Bills, it's very important to be able to get your hands up. Remember last season, we deflected so many passes at the line of scrimmage. AJ Epenesa is going to come in and help us do that even more. If you can't get to the quarterback, second best thing is to get your hands up, deflect some passes. You never know what's going to happen with those deflected balls. Remember, the first interception this season for the Buffalo Bills was in week two, and it was by Trent Murphy. So no one had that coming. I still remember talking to Mario from Hashtag Sports about it. So that's the type of situation that you can get here with AJ Epenesa. He actually deflected 7 balls during his career at Iowa, so he knows how to get his hands up. He knows how to get some deflected passes, which may lead to some interceptions at the other end. So really good thing to have there, that length at the defensive end position. We can obviously talk about his youth, right? Obviously, young man drafted. We needed to have youth at that defensive end position. You look at Jerry Hughes, you look at Trent Murphy, you look at some of our ends that we have. Not exactly spring chickens anymore. Some of these guys might be on their way out as well at the end of this season due to contracts expiring. So it's time to get a young guy in there, revamp those defensive ends, and get ready for the future. We don't just want to be a division winning team next season. We want to be an AFC East division powerhouse for a long time to come, and a pick like AJ Epenesa helps that happen. Another one of my pros is he has a great first step. If you watch his first step in college, he has a great first step putting offensive tackles on their toes immediately. Now, in the NFL, obviously he's gonna have to work on that a little bit more. You're not playing against the same college level, collegiate level players that you will be playing in the NFL. These are NFL top 32-64 offensive tackles in the game that you're going to be playing against. But remember, if he's on a rotational basis, he'll hopefully be playing against them at 100% when the offensive tackle maybe has been out there for a full series, maybe has been out there for a full 2.5 quarters and just doesn't have the speed in his legs that he did at the beginning of the game. That's when you can see a burst like AJ Epenesa has really come into effect. Now, he's not great with the bull rush, right? Now, that's one of his cons, is he's not great at the force rush, but he has a great first step, a great first move, able to get into the B gap and force the running back to go outside. We talk about how he's not great in the running attack, or at least that's where we want to see a lot of improvement. But one thing that he does is he gives the linebackers a chance to make tackles in the backfield, because he makes the running back, when he comes into that B gap, makes the running back run around him, and that gives linebackers a chance to read the play and get into the backfield, hopefully make a play. And really, those are the things that don't show up on the stat sheet, right? The type of guy that gets in there is able to force a running back to take that sidestep in the backfield or force him to the outside, and then all of a sudden a linebacker can come across, get that tackle. All of a sudden you have a linebacker getting credit for a tackle that really you could give a half tackle to that defensive end who really busted up the play from the beginning. You saw that a lot in Iowa. We hope to see that a lot for the Buffalo Bills moving forward. Another one of his pros is he has multiple moves to get past the tackle. I talked about how he's not good with the bull rush, but he's great with his arms. He has a double arm move that he can do that he used in Iowa. If you watch his film, he has a spin move that's pretty good as well. So if he continues to work on those things, he will continue to improve and continue to maybe slide past some offensive tackles who, again, might not be expecting that bolt of a first step that he has, and then he gets by them real quick. That's why you see him in the backfield so often. That's why you're talking about 37 sacks in 3 seasons with Iowa, if not more, if I'm not mistaken. Because he has that big first step, he has a couple of good moves that he can use against an offensive tackle to deceive an offensive tackle into not knowing what he's going to do next. Very important to have that as a defensive end. Have multiple moves to get past an offensive tackle, kind of keep him on his toes. It's great if you have that bull rush, and maybe that's something that the defensive coordinator Leslie Frazier can work on for AJ Epenesa. But if you can have moves that get past them as well, if you can work on that bull rush, right, and then you have multiple, then the offensive tackle is just not going to know how you're going to attack him. And that's very important when you're talking about an NFL next level offensive tackle. An offensive tackle can normally match you straight up, right? However, if he doesn't know what you're doing, if he has to second guess himself at the snap onto what you're doing, then he's less likely to be effective, and you can possibly get by him quicker than you would if he knows how you're attacking him. So maybe work on the bull rush a little bit, but other than that, some great moves for AJ Epenesa. And again, a guy who was at one point mocked to go as high as to the 10 to 15 range. So you really gotta be happy with this pick at 54. We'll be playing, like I said, in a rotational style defense. The Buffalo Bills do a great job rotating their defensive ends. So I expect that to really benefit, especially because he's young and he doesn't have the moves that you want him to have as far as the bull rush. Maybe get a quicker second, third step so he can get past offensive tackles quicker. And then that will improve his game. Learn behind a Jerry Hughes, learn behind a Trent Murphy, and see what you can do when Trent Murphy might be gone at the end of next season, or whatever the case might be, where we have to ask for more out of you in the future. One of my negatives is he's not going to beat offensive tackles with his bull rush. That's what we talked about, and I'll continue to talk about that. Maybe get a little bit bigger. We know that he has the size to do it. Now maybe get a little bit more of that toughness, right? Coach McDermott always talking about that toughness. Maybe now is one of these times where you bring in this player. You brought in Jefferson earlier this year. Maybe he's the type of guy who can show AJ Epenesa how to get a little bit more toughness in his game. Not be afraid to bull rush a guy, and again, add that extra move for his repertoire. So again, guys, let me know what you think about the Buffalo Bills' second round draft pick, the first draft pick for the Buffalo Bills in the 2020 NFL draft, AJ Epenesa. Again, initial thoughts by me: right position, wrong guy. I was really looking at Weaver out of Boise State, but you can't argue with the fact that this guy, Epenesa, was one of the best players available at the time, and that's who Brandon Bean and the Buffalo Bills pick. So I'm happy with the pick. I'm glad that we got the defensive end. We got some youth there. And I think the Buffalo Bills are one of those teams that's a good fit for Epenesa. We know that that Leslie Frazier, Coach McDermott, know how to get the best out of these defensive guys, and it looks like they've done it again, hopefully getting the best out of AJ Epenesa for a long time to come. Again, guys, tell me what you think. If you haven't already subscribed to Believers Talk, we'll be posting another video probably tonight going over our third round pick. So look forward to that. Hit that notification bell, like this video, and leave a comment. What do you think about the Buffalo Bills' second round 2020 NFL draft pick, AJ Epenesa? I look forward to talking to you all soon, bringing you more NFL draft coverage. Until I do, go Bills.